I want to say welcome everyone here to our spring concert. They've given us an invitation to let the song begin, and I hope you enjoy the evening here, enjoy the hard work that they have put into the spring concert here. I'm proud of what they have to offer here tonight, but also hope that this evening draws you to worship as well, and that through these songs you can maybe get a different perspective or a better perspective of who God is and our relationship with him. So after my opening remarks here, there will be a song by the kindergarten class. And then after they are finished, if the light, we'll turn the lights on, and if the kindergarten parents could stand, and we'll let the kindergartners go back to their parents, sit with their parents for the remainder of the evening. So I will turn it over to them.
thank you all for coming out this evening. Our theme is Who is on the Lord's Side? And there were 3 points that I wish to highlight in my selection of songs for this evening. The first is, it's not enough to simply say that you're on the Lord's side. There is a price to pay, and there is work to do. The second point, on the other hand, is there are great rewards to being on the Lord's side, and if you're on the Lord's side, you can't lose. I hope it will be fairly self-explanatory how each of the selections this evening lines up with one or more of those points, and I hope that you will be challenged and inspired and take a firm stand on the Lord's side.
My such a blessing to see our children worshiping through song. And it just blesses my heart that the teachers working so hard to teach them the music, working with our children each and every day. Christian education is such a blessing, and it's a blessing to see you as parents here this evening. I'm just blessed by your attendance. To see parents interested in education is a real, real boost for the board, and especially me as a treasurer. This evening, our offering is going to be for some curriculum expenses. Now, at Fairhaven Christian School, we try to do our best to offer a good product to you as a parent, right? We want our children to learn all those things they're supposed to learn. And this evening, it's about history. For fifth and sixth grade, we are changing curriculums. We can no longer get some of the curriculums, some of the components, testing components from the curriculum we were using, so we're switching the fifth and sixth grade history curriculum to a new one. And with that comes some expenses. You know, you got to buy textbooks and the teacher guides and all that stuff. And so this evening, you have the opportunity of joining in that expense. And the offering tonight will go to help cover some of the costs of that curriculum. It's going to cost right around $2,500 to make that change. And so that's what the offering will be going toward this evening. The ushers, you guys can come front right now to lift the offering, to receive the offering. I'm going to have a prayer. I'm going to ask you to stand for the prayer. And so you can get to your wallet. Let's pray. Father, I thank you for Fairhaven Christian School. Thank you for the teachers, their hard work. Thank you for the children and their worship through song. And Father, I just pray real blessing now on the parents too. Thank you for their hard work in the home. And Father, we want our children to do well in school. We want our teachers to have good resources. I pray, Father, that as we lift this offering and purchase some new history curriculum, that it would be a blessing here for our school in the years to come. We pray this in your name. Amen. Please stay standing. I'm going to put Elvin on the spot here. Elvin Stahlsfuss, come up front here and help me sing a song. We're going to sing Lift Your Glad Voices. Yep, Elvin, you come up here. Sorry, I didn't give you him a warning. He don't know this yet. Come up front here. The song's going to be Lift Your Glad Voices. I think Elvin knows how to start it. Lift Your Glad Voices. You're going to start it. Oh. Elvin's going to start it.
Okay. Lift your glad voices in triumph.
Be seated.
Our next piece is the song that Moses and the children of Israel sang after they had walked through the Red Sea on dry land and the Lord had overthrown Pharaoh and all his host in the Red Sea. Well, at least the lyrics are that song. I don't know whether it would be possible at this point in history to know for certain what tune they sang it to, but this is a real Israeli folk song, so it could be the tune for anything you know. And from the biblical description, it appears that Moses and the men started out the song, and it was sung as a round with Miriam, Moses' sister, and the women following. So we have the boys starting out and the girls coming in.
Thank you.
nothing at all. I looked into this. Some of the students said, you know, it sounds like it has something to do with a horse. And I said, well, I know where you're coming from, but this doesn't come from Lancaster County. This comes from Israel, so I don't think there's any connection. On second thoughts, actually, Yiddish, I understand, is like 85% German, so there could be a connection, who knows. But according to anything I've read about this song, the actual phrase, Zum Gali Gali, is simply nonsense syllables. There are other words to this song, which we will be singing in English instead of the original Hebrew. Now the next song, Artsa Alinu, on the other hand, well, I'll tell you about that when we get there. Okay, when you're giving a performance, you're never supposed to let the audience know that you made mistakes and hope that they won't notice it anyway, but if you did notice those two bad starts on the last two songs, don't blame the students. It was 100% the fault of their scatterbrained director. And now, as far as Artsa Alinu is concerned, Artsa Alinu is actually a real Hebrew phrase, and it translates as something like, we are going up into the land. I understand that to the Jewish mind, this is especially associated with the idea of going up into the promised land to take possession. The English translation that we will be using today, sorry, the English text that we'll be using today is not actually a translation of the original Hebrew, but a collection of Bible passages on related subjects, referencing primarily the words of Caleb and Joshua when the other 10 spies had made the hearts of the children of Israel faint. So we'll be singing, let us go up, the land is before us. Be not dismayed, Jehovah fights for us. Though we go forth to labor with weeping, we shall rejoice in due season reaping. Our foes shall flee before us. Fear not, the Lord fights for us.
Shall flee before us. Fear not, the Lord fights. You ask me how I know you live. let your light shine.
Oh, let your light
do you shine.
Let it shine like it never did before.
Let it shine all around you.
Let
so everyone will know you are filled with the glory of the Lord.
Of the Lord.
Your light will shine, shine, shine.
Hallelujah, let it shine with the glory of the Lord. Go on and shine, shine, shine.
Well, thank you, students. I think we should give them another hand. Very well done. And thank you, Ms. Schwant and teachers, for your hard work. We've been looking forward to this sometime. And we've heard a number of these songs around our house now for a few months, some of them more than others, and we've learned to appreciate most of them and learn some of them ourselves. We were encouraged tonight, and the big question tonight was, who is on the Lord's side? Who will stand with God? And Ms. Schwant made it clear to us at the beginning that there's a price to pay to do that. It's not always easy, but she also mentioned the benefits and the privileges and the rewards that come with that. We were encouraged at the beginning to let the song begin with a joyful voice. I really appreciated the kindergarten song, I Wonder How It Felt. If you ever wondered how it felt to sleep beside a smelly kangaroo in the ark, you're clearly not the only one. And I think that speaks to God being all-knowing and us having lots of questions, but going to God for those answers. And then we were also encouraged to let your light shine and to be an overcomer. So thank you, students, Ms. Schwant, teachers, for your hard work tonight. I want to thank those of you who came out tonight. Thank you for your support, showing that by your presence tonight. Thank you also for the offering. Came out to $1,859, so that gets us pretty far along with our curriculum purchase, so thank you for your support with that. A couple announcements and we'll close. Children are asked to stay in the gym tonight to just keep everything a little bit more under control, not run all over the school. So stay in the gym, children. Fifth and eighth boys are asked to help clear out the chairs, and those of you that are here can feel free to help with that as well. So let's have a closing prayer. And then you can consider yourselves dismissed. Father, thank you for this opportunity tonight. And as it's been said before, thank you for the opportunity to have a Christian school that honors you, teachers that honor you, patrons that care about you, that honor you, students that want to serve you. What a blessing that is. Thank you for our time of worship here tonight, for being with us, for guiding us this far in the school year. Be with the students and teachers in the next couple of days of school before we let out for the summer and then bring us back together in the fall. Thank you for being with us this school year. Continue to guide us. In Jesus' name, amen. You are dismissed.